Hi guys, welcome back to the ALSHE project. This video is to do a small improvement or big improvement, depending on the or how you take it, and a few corrections from the latest version. For example, in the latest version, I realized that when you are in first person and you aim, you were able to see all the weapons together. So, in example, you have three weapons. The three weapons were presented when aiming, so this is corrected now. Also, the X button that were appearing on top of the items, they were, in example, you had the item in here, and you put 20 on top. It will be presented here, but if the item change its position, let's say it drops to the table or to this mesh, the X button will remain in the same position. So now this is corrected as well, and the X button is going where the mesh is going. I have improved, I will say a lot, or a lot, depending on how you take it as well, the first person view, especially the weapons. Now there is no iron sights like before, that you were depending on the iron sights to shoot. Now it will be presented a new camera. The new camera is distorted or displaced, and the icon, the aiming icon, is still present in there. Also, I have improved a bit the opening door. I have created a new switch, and that it will be, you can choose how to open. Let me show you. Simplify, you open this door and you go to the opening. There is a new node in here that is open door with options, so you can do the approach and animation, that is the character is walking to the door, opening it with the animation, the opening animation. You can do the full method. The full method means that it will be walking to the door, opening it with animation, and then putting the IK for the hands. Just open, that will be just open it without any animation, without any approach, without anything. There is another option, that just open on FPS, on first person, just open. I will show how this works now. So just for you to know that this method, this node, is in here. Okay. It is the same for this door as well. So okay. So also, I have added the X button to all the these triggers. Say this is the wheel trigger. This is the lever, the book, the torch, this is the picture, and the button. So all of them have the X now implemented. All of them are opening or closing this door. So I will show you now. I have corrected as well the flashlight, and also the best thing, I have improved a bit the how to move or how to place the left hand on the weapons. Also, before, I noticed that the left hand was a bit laggy. Let's say that you were aiming, and then the left hand were moving like it was behind 2-3 frames or even more. Now this is corrected as well. So let me show you everything. Let me try to show everything now. So let me do an example. Now in example, you can see that the left hand, sorry that my computer is a bit laggy sometimes, is not lagging. You see? Also, if I go to first person, you will see now it is the weapon, the aiming position. You see that the left hand is not lagging at all. Also, you can see the aiming icon in there. I will show where this goes. Perfectly to the icon. You can see that now the first person view is a bit up forward. So you can see this. There is no problem. Also, when you aim to the top, it is sometimes so I don't know if we to clamp this somehow. It should tell me. So this is another weapon. As you can see, it's not lagging, and also the left hand is there. This is the one hand aiming for the pistol. Let me show you how it is the two hands. The two hands, of course, the animation are up to you. You can see the X button in first person is also good. Also, let me show you how it is the animation in there. I show you. Let me turn off. So I show you that when it is in third person, I wanted to open it by doing the approach and also the animation, right? So if I go, it's working to it and doing the animation. Way, this is the same, but when it is on first person, now it will just open. I think it's better for first person just to open, or maybe to just to run a animation or something, you will decide. Sequence trigger. So now let me show you the triggers for this. You can do it with the left hand, with the left button, or you can use the X. Up to you. In the same way, you can do all of these. Also for the book. For the torch. Picture. Or the button. Also, the animations are now running on the on this. So you shot an example with this one. You will see how the shooting or recharging it is. You see how it is moving the hand. So you can play. Last thing, an example is this in first person. I wanted to correct it as well. Now you can go and play. Anywhere. Also, now I will show you the way to place the first person camera. If you go to any of the characters, for example, this is the this is this character. In this character, this is the first person camera. This is the where you can move up, you can move down, you can move left. It will be taken from here. Okay. This is the character Kevin. You can see it in here. What it is. Okay. Now an example for Kevin. The way I'm hiding the head, an example when I'm aiming, it is by, if you go to the head here, to the face, sorry, I put a tag that is iron sight hide. Okay, because I created a new method that is hiding all everything that you want when it is in iron sights. So the head in example is hidden. If you have a single mesh, it will, this is hide the head, that is not this one. Let me try to go to the base character. Something new as well. So make mesh parts hidden. So you need to provide if they will be hidden or not. So you can use for hiding them or to showing them again. You can use a bone name, like in example, if you have a single mesh, like this character that have a single mesh, have no head mesh or no separated mesh, you can hide by bone. So this is why I'm putting here a bone, so you can parse the bone head in example and it will be hidden. Also it will be hidden by tag, so it will find everything that you provide a tag and will be hidden in game. It is very important that in example if I play here now, I will go iron sights, but you see that still the head is in the shadows. Is casting shadows, right? It is very important for that you go to the character in the face, in example, you can find for hidden, and it is hidden shadow, that it will be casting shadows, even if it is hidden. Okay, so this is the trick. If you don't put this, look, if I remove this, I will play. You see, the head has disappeared. So this is important to gain in reality, in realism. And that's it. I believe nothing more. I think this is much more improved for the guys that want to have a first person game more than a third person. Of course, everything that I have said is not happening when you have a third person. None of the other methods that you have been seen here, they are triggered when you are in third person. Everything is as normal. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed this video, this version. I hope you can take advantage of it. Thank you very much for all the support, and I hope you continue supporting me during the time of this project. Okay, so thank you very much. Bye.